Hi everybody, welcome to my channel. Today we're going to demonstrate how to make an arbitrary mounting on a semi-adjustable articulator. Before we start this exercise, it's important to set up our articulator. For this, we need to put the incisal pin in zero, have the mechanical table straight, and get some mounting rings. It's highly recommended to lubricate your articulator so it's easy to clean afterwards. We're going to set up the horizontal contour guidance to 0 degrees. The flat end of the anterior guiding pin should be centered on the line of the mechanical guide table. And finally, we need to prepare the cast for mounting, so make sure you have your index and notches. Click on the link below in the description to see a video on how to do it.
Okay, the next step is put the two casts together, you know, to make sure they are properly occluding. So for that, we're going to use a thumb presser. This time the person in half and okay, in a half as well. What you need is about 2.5 inches. So I have 4 pieces here. I'm gonna need adhesive. Okay, adhesive. You can use rice glue. You can use heat gun like this, or you can use you can even use the compound material to glue these guys. The idea is to put 3 or 4 points. So both casts are stable, so we're going to start. So here we have the same adjustable articulator. We're gonna need some wax, rough wax, and the whole idea is to put this cast in between the upper and lower arm of your articulator. So you also want the occlusal plane to be right in between, and you need at least 3 degrees of angulation, just like that. Right, so it's hard to do that when you're mixing the stone. So what we're doing now, we're gonna put a little wax here, and we're gonna create a mounting guide with that. So I'm gonna put some wax. Here, so make sure again this is, it's got some 3 or 5 degrees angulation. This occlusal plane is in between the two arches, and this from the center is nice, from the top is nice and center. Okay, so again, you want to have your midline pretty much in, so midline is good. The right and left side are pretty much center and the occlusal. Let me just show you. Pretty much center. Okay. From the side, you want to give yourself about 3 degrees in angulation. Not too crazy, but definitely the occlusal plane, you want to make it in between the upper and lower arm. What we're using here is some wax that we put it. This is a sticky wax or rope wax. We're using complete inches to help us to position this cast. Because now it's much faster to open this guy and to put it past. Okay, so we are ready to mount. So one of the things I tell my students is to put a little Vaseline in this upper and lower arm before you put the plate. This is gonna help you to remove any kind of wax. When it kind of stumps, sorry, that might get into the articulator, you know, how hard to remove. So now you're ready, you put this plate. So after it's Vaseline, you put the plate. We're gonna latch these guys, one and two, okay? So we're gonna make sure these are 0 degrees when you mount it, 0 degrees, and make sure you have space in between. Well, in other words, it closes. Okay, just verify everything, and we're ready. Okay, so it's time to do the mounting. So we have a bowl, and we have the mounting plaster ready to go. The consistency we're gonna use is rather creamy. We don't want the hard consistency. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna lift this arm. I'm gonna drop some stone. Okay, so our priority is to kind of capture those mounting guys we did. Like a layer all around. Especially those mounting. Then I like to put something in the mounting plate too. That's where the Vaseline is important. So if something drips, it's okay because you're Vaseline, so it's just gonna, wash right off. And then you're gonna put a little extra into your upper arm. So now you can close your articulator, of course I already checked my incision that is appropriate. From here you can do many things. I like not to disturb too much, so let's clean it out the rough out excess. We can always come back and finesse it a little bit and polish it. Don't go too crazy. Just add as needed, remove the excess that are on your way. It would be nice, of course, to have everything finished now, but you know, we'll still need to add more stone or plaster later. Build yourself some negative error, positive error, bro. Because it's some positive error, so you can turn this one away. Okay, if you want, you can use your finger. Kind of smooth it away. So this is pretty much set. Now what we're doing is we need to turn upside down the articulator, just like that. Okay. Now very carefully we're gonna open this, just like that. Okay. And now we're gonna mount the mandibular. Okay. So now we're going to the lower arch. Likewise. I'm gonna put Vaseline first, so it's easy to clean out the stone. If you get some stone there, it's easy. So what I did, I had this mounting plate here, so I removed the wax. And in this case, I have another mounting plate, but if you don't, that's fine. You can use the same one. Just clean and make sure you have a space. Okay, so you have a space. It should be fine. Now we're gonna put the plaster here, and we're gonna close this. That's it. Okay, let's do that. All right, same consistency there. Good. So I'm gonna add it here. You see, accidents happen. So clean it out real quick. That's why I like to put Vaseline, because, you know, it's easy to remove. Over this. Make sure I have all the borders captured. And now, put a little bit on the mounting plate. So make it too runny because it's gonna drip all over the place. So mounting plate, make sure you capture all these details. So actually it locks in. That's enough. Now we have overbuilt it here. So now we can close it. What's this? And now the job is to clean up. Pretty good. In this case, I run out of stone, but that's okay. All right, so this is already set. So I'm gonna remove these markings. These mounting things that we put. Now we can turn it over. We can open and close. Let's go, right? So now we need to clean all this mess. So of course we need to add and remove. So let's remove this. Remove this guy. And also the lower arm. First thing I do is I'm gonna move my camera here. I think I'm gonna wash this better. So I use Vaseline just about everywhere. So all the stone, all the plaster around, it just literally washed out. Okay, so I don't like messy articulators, supposed to be absolutely clean. So what are we doing now? We have this and this ones, and we need to add more stone to it. So let's do that. I already have a mix of stone ready to go. What I do is any single area that I need to put, just add it to it. If I miss something. I'm gonna miss a little bit here. This is fine. Manipular arch. Basically adding stone to it. Make sure it's over bulk so you can remove. And again, this stone is going to set pretty quickly, so I need to go more fast. So this guy, it can be messy if you want now, but really, I'd rather just wait a little longer. Okay. I'm just gonna wait for this. Pick up one also, I'm gonna wait. For finishing up, we're gonna use our sponge. So this one is coarse. This is fine grit, and there's the ultra fine grit. With this one, we're gonna make it really smooth, okay? Okay, so how to make it nice, so go with the buffalo, start cleaning all these areas. Clean it good. Okay. take your time. There's gonna be some areas that you have bubbles and voids. That's okay. We still have some stone here, so we can put it in there. You can finish it like that. Leave that alone. The upper arch, the other arch before it sets, let's start cleaning it up. A little bit there. Let's see. Okay. I normally like to clean the base first. Make sure the base is nice and clean. Start with the base. And from the base, you can double down. This one is set. So we're gonna clean out the teeth and brush. Do that brush. Really, really quick. Don't want to flush. That's good. And the other one. Good. And now we're gonna use. We have two different sponges, one coarse and the other one regular or fine. So I'm gonna go with the coarse first. Right, and it's gonna go sideways. Okay. Like so. Sideways. And it's gonna take care of business. This one gives you the shining, especially for presentation. You want to show up with a really nice one. This is the one. Just need to take your time. Let's get there. Okay. That's pretty good. Now to the lower. Same idea. With the lower, I'm gonna go with the coarse red, which is this one right here, and we're gonna go sideways. Cleaning first the any stone, any plaster from the base. And you work your way around. You gotta clean it from time to time because it just clogs up pretty easily.
So I see students doing this when the stone hasn't been removed. You need to do the gross reduction first, so which means that you gotta remove first the, with something like this, you're gonna remove all the gross excess. And then with this one, you can kind of go again and try to remove whatever you can remove. You're ready to present the case, ready to do whatever. Also, clean out your articulator because output mounting doesn't finish when your articulator is clean. It could be a scratch here and there, but it has to be clean, no stone. And if you put Vaseline, if you do the Vaseline trick, that'll do it. Okay, so now put the presentation.
Alright guys, don't forget about finesse. So thank you for watching my video and don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell button to get alerts every time I drop a new content. I will see you later. Bye.